This is the Fisher-Price PXL 2000 camcorder. It was launched in 1987 as a children's toy, and over the years has gained a bit of a cult following. While its advertising may lead you to believe it's the perfect tool for capturing 80s action, the actual image produced is a ghostly pixelated dreamscape that's more at home with a Burial soundtrack than anything by Wham. The more I looked into this camera, the more interesting it became. Firstly, as far as I'm aware, this is the only camera to record onto a standard audio cassette. And there might be a reason for that, because the picture quality is truly awful. But that's all part of the charm. And while you probably wouldn't film an entire project on this thing, there's something to be said for using it as a physical effect rather than slapping on a filter in Premiere. I was introduced to the camera by Daniel McGee, who has a heavily modified version that he used on projects like his Ben Ramer's Cons edit to great effect. I quickly learned that the Pixel Vision has been used all over the shop. Most notably, it was used to film an entire sequence in the 1991 Linklater film, Slacker. But it was also used for a Sonic Youth music video and for certain scenes in the David Lynch produced vampire flick, Nadia. I got my PXL 2000 on eBay and it was sold as spares or repair. Opening it up, I found that an LED had come desoldered, and one of the belts for the tape heads had worn out. You know how we roll on this channel though. We're going tapeless. So I fixed the LED, and we're off to a good start. So after a lot of trawling the crusty blogs of the old internet, and a bit of tinkering, here's where I'm at. First I had to add an AV out, as the standard Pixel Vision only has a TV hookup for old school RF tuners. Luckily, I was able to find the info without too much difficulty. After disassembly, you'll need to remove a metal shielding panel. You can either melt the solder tacks and pry it up, or cut through the solder with some side cutters. After removal, I found that it didn't have a noticeable effect on the video signal, so I chose to remove it entirely by cutting along the perforated edge. The video signal can be taken from here, next to the corner of the PCB on the third pin up. There's loads of options for ground, but I chose this one here as it had a nice big solder blob to tack onto. I drilled a hole in the left side casing and hooked up a nice gold-plated RCA connector that I got from Amazon. I planned to stick an audio out in the same area, but the terminals I used were on the larger side and wouldn't fit next to each other. As it stands, I haven't added an audio out, as I can't imagine I'll actually ever need the audio from this thing. But if you want to wire one up, the audio out pin is the next one up from the video signal, with the long trace on the PCB. I've been told that hooking up to this connection will prevent audio recording to the cassette, so that's worth keeping in mind if you plan to use tapes as well. For the battery connection, I used this neat little MPF battery plate from Small Rig. It's on the pricey side at around 40 quid, but the build quality is fantastic. It provides both 7.4 volt and 12 volt DC outputs, and we'll be needing the 12 volt for this camera. I mounted it in a way that makes it easily removed if you want to use it with other cameras too. I chopped off the battery terminal at the front of the camera and wired up a barrel jack. Then I drilled a hole in the battery door and connected the plate using a 1/4-20 to hot shoe adapter. I planned to use a normal 1/4-20 bolt, but the ones I had were too short, so this ended up working surprisingly well, with there being just enough room in the recess of the battery plate for the hot shoe adapter to fit. I snipped another notch in the battery door for the power cable to slip through, and Bob's your uncle. Batteries last forever on this thing, and I already have a bunch for the TRV900, so I'm pretty pleased with this setup. For the DVR, we'll of course be using the trusty PowerPlay. To mount it, I used one of the sticky pads from a GoPro accessory kit and slapped it onto the back of one of my 3D printed mounts. Then I just attached it to the flat area under the viewfinder. It handles the weight just fine, and it's pretty convenient to remove and reattach. So that's about it. Now I can create pixelated monochrome hellscapes wherever I go. I'd love to do some more mods on this camera, but the information is extremely hard to come by. People have done all sorts of wild circuit bending to create glitchy effects. I'm not really sure where to start. My Pixel Vision has a tendency to overexpose, and as standard the only adjustment is via the ND on the front, which ain't quite cutting it. So the exposure dial mod is a must for me, and if anyone knows where to solder to, please shoot me a message. Thanks for watching, hope you found it interesting. Hit subscribe so you don't miss future projects, and I'll catch you in the next one. Toodles!